Hey guys, and welcome back to Avatar The Last Airbender book 3 episode number 21. This is the final episode. If you guys have not watched the previous episode, two episodes reaction, I've already put it out. Both this video and those previous two episode video reactions will be put out at the same time. So if you have not checked that out, check that out first and then come to this. So yeah, we're finally at the end. This is the final episode. I'm going to watch it, and obviously I'm going to give my little, you know, review on Avatar, how I loved it and all that stuff. And after it ends, and then I'll talk about what my future plans are with Korra. So yeah, let's get started with this episode. We kind of ended at a cliffhanger, so let's continue. So I'll be putting the subtitles and the timer here. Sync it to whichever is your preference, and let's get started. Right, so here's the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. So since comment part 4, after Aang. All right. Yep, it's heating up. Oh God. Oh, okay. Wait, what? Oh. My God. Wow. Haha, nice. Okay, my God. Oh no. Oh, oh no, oh my God, look at his leg. Oh no. Oh my God, what do we do now? Suki. Nice! Ooh! Good! Oh my God, okay, what now? Wait, what? Oh my God! Oh my God, okay. Oh. Okay, that's what, okay. Oh. Like, it's extremely, like, look at him, he's sweating. Like, this is extremely hot inside. What do we do now? Oh no. Okay. Oh. Oh no. Did he go into his avatar state? What's happening? Wait. I think he went into avatar state. Oh my God. Oh. Wow. Well, Ozai, what are you going to do now? You should have cut that beard because, yeah, it's working against you. Well, he's dead. Oh! Ozai, you messed up! You've awoken that one thing that you shouldn't have. Your world domination power is now down the drain. Okay, Oh my god, yeah. Oh my. Okay, he's combining all the elements. Oza is dead. Ooh. Okay. Oopsie. Oh. God. Okay, here he is. Nice. Well, we've captured Ba Sing Se. Ooh! He's been talking smack for quite a while. Now who's like. Oh! Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Okay, he's okay. Okay. No, I think your family physician needs to look at you first because you're crazy now. Okay, what? Like, lightning won't work with water bending. Like, oh, damn. Okay. Oh, yes, water. Okay, a little bit. There you go now. Yes! Freeze it! Yep. Oh, katana, nice! Come on, a little bit more. That was cool. That was fascinating. Okay, heal him quick. All right. I doubt he'll die. He's always. Okay, there you go. Okay. Quick, Azula, let's get to her first. I'm concerned she's going to do something. Okay. Oh. Okay, he's running now. He's like, yep, I'm screwed up. I probably should have waited a few more days. Look at him run. Oh. A few moments ago, he was talking about how he'll be the Phoenix or whatever. Okay, Oh my. Oh. My God. How the tables turned. I was waiting for this moment. I wanted to see him, like, you know, scream in fear. I'm talking about Ozai. I really wanted to see that. And yeah, I'm pretty much satisfied now. There you go. Yes. I think he'll not do it. Oh my. Okay. Yeah, he won't do it. There you go. He controlled it. No, don't. Oh no, don't do that. Oh my God, this guy is. Ozai is going to try to strike you from the back or something. There you go. Oh, great. You know what? Just. Okay, what's. Okay, yeah, just seal him or want something. I don't know, like. Whoa, what? Oh, wow. That's what the turtle did. Is he going to change him from the inside or something? My God, what's happening? Okay. Oh. Come on, Aang. Come on, Aang, come on. Oh no. Aang! There you go. He needs to overpower it. Okay, there you go. Nice. So he'll become good? Ozai will become good or something? Is that what's going to happen? Oh, he took out his five ending. Okay, that's better. Yeah, it's time for you to retire, Ozai. Wow. Nice. Wow, that's okay. That's a great way to end this, I have to say. Like, he did not take his life. He basically took away his five ending, which is an appropriate punishment, you can say. No more. Nice, the comet is gone. We've won the war. Thank you, Saga, for the demonstration. No, he... Yeah, just take away his power. Okay, Saka, don't start. Don't start, Saka. Oh, great. Here we go. Yeah. That was bad. Okay, what? Oh, Basin says already captured. I was like, what happened there? Okay. Nice! There you go. Happy ending. Zuko's now Fire Lord. Oh, my. I was like, okay. Well, obviously. All right, there you go. Happy ending. Okay. What happened to Azula? I'm thinking about it. What happened to... Oh, his leg. Okay. I wonder what happened to Zuko's mother. Like... The... Wait, what? Did he join them? Did she join them? Oh, she was in the same prison. Okay. It's kind of interesting to see like how she said, I never wanted to be part of a same pack, but now they're... Okay, I'll talk about it later. Nice. Ah, there you go. Avatar and the Fire Lord working together. Yep, there you go. New Fire Lord Zuko. Yep. What happened to Azula? Is she in prison? I think so, yeah. And maybe Ozai is also here. Who's that? Is that that's Ozai. Shut up. Don't act like this was not your fault. Yeah. Don't think so. I don't think this guy can change. What? Where's mom? Yeah, where's mom? Okay. What the? What is happening? Are they like. Ah, the new tea shop. Wow, look at that. Is he painting? He doesn't. Oh my god, he's very bad at painting. Yeah, let's see the painting. Oh my god. Wow. Probably. All right. Okay, there you go. Well, happy ending. All right. The end. Okay, is there anything else left? I think that's the end. Okay, let me check if there's something in the end or not. Just a sec. No, I don't think there's anything in the end. Yep, that's the end. Okay, so that was it. That was episode number 21, the final episode of After the Last Airbender, Book 3. And yep, that ended in a very what can I say? Very good way. Now, there are a few questions that are still unanswered. Number one, what happened to Azula? We did see Ozai there. So I'm guessing Azula's probably also in the prison cell somewhere. Another question unanswered, where's the mom? Where's Zuko's mom? Now here's the thing. I do know that there are a few comics after this which actually probably answers these questions, which I'll check out later on, you know. And I'm really interested in knowing what happened to Zuko's mom. And you know what will happen to Azula after this and all that stuff. I want to know. I'll check the comic out later on. So okay, let me first talk about this episode and then I'll give my little review, my impressions of Avatar as a whole, and what I'm going to do after this. So here in this episode, in the beginning, excuse me. Okay, here in the beginning, we are in the middle of the battle between Sokka and all that, and Toph and Suki, the battle in the middle of the air. Sokka obviously is obviously now he's very proficient in using weapons. He kind of, like, you know, like, what do you call it, saves all of them, Toph and himself as well, in that situation. And he holds on to Toph. Like, obviously Toph cannot do in the middle of the sky, can't do anything, she's blind. So, like, that, and Suki comes in, like, you know, in the end, and, like, you know, helps them out. That was, like, that whole situation, and it really shows us how Sokka improved, and how but his boomerang did not come back this time, I guess. But Suki did come back, so yeah. Yeah, and that was that. And then we get to the, like, you know, okay, let me talk one by one. First, let's talk about Azula's situation. Azula, I was really impressed by how Katara handled that situation. That was fantastic. Like, I never would have thought you can do something like that. Like, the way Katara used her waterbending, like, she's not only a waterbending master, but she also knows how to properly utilize it. So here we see, like, you know, obviously they were fighting, and Katara is heavily disadvantaged against Azula, because if she uses waterbending, Azula can easily use lightning and just, like, you know, zap her. And fire, water does overpower fire, but not against lightning. So in a way, she was heavily overpowered. Like, you know, and I really thought she was going to use bloodbending here. She did not. I was quite surprised at that. And like, she could have just ended everything then if she was bloodbending. But as I, like, you know, as we can see, like, she probably did not want to do that, because bloodbending in itself is some type of, is a thing that we should, like, you know, no one should ever use. It's like a taboo thing. So she did not do that. I'm guessing if she really was in, like, you know, a lot of trouble, if there was no other chance, she would have probably used bloodbending. But she had the chance to actually overpower Azula, and she tried that out. She actually lured her in the on top of the sewer. And you know what, if Azula was actually in sane mind, you know, if she was not troubled by all of these different situations and everything, if she was not crazy completely, she would have probably saw that coming. Azula's pretty intelligent, so her state of mind played a big role here for her actually not realizing that she's been lured into a trap. And she gets in on top of the netted thing, the sewer thing that was underneath. And I was really impressed by the way Katara did that. Like, I thought that she was going to only use water to, like, you know, knock her out or something. But no, she used the water to put both of them inside there. She frees both of them, used water bending to unfreeze herself, and then used the chain to chain her up to the sewer thing. That was impressive. I was not expecting something like that. That was really great use of her waterbending technique and using this environments to actually overpower Azula. And she succeeded. So, and obviously Azula now, obviously she can't do anything. And she was trying using firebending through her mouth and all that, but yeah, nothing you can do about that. She's chained up, and Katara goes and helps Zuko out. And yeah, that was an appropriate end, I guess. Azula got captured, and I feel really bad for her when she started crying, because yeah, she realized that it's over, like, everything's over, all that she has done. And like, you know, she doesn't have any friends, she's captured, all that stuff. And yeah, I really hope she changes. Like, and I really hope they find their mom, because if Zuko finds her mom and brings her back, I'm sure Azula will change. Like, you know, we have seen that she is redeemable. There is a part of her heart which can be redeemed. But I don't think the same about Ozai. I don't think Ozai can be redeemed. I'm sorry about that. But yeah, he doesn't seem like a person who would change. Who knows? Maybe as time goes, you know, like, as they say, time can change a lot of people. So maybe in the future, like 20, 30 years later, maybe when he'll be an old man, he'll be like, oh, I finally understand what I did wrong. My eyes have opened. I shouldn't have done that. Maybe. maybe in the future, but not now. He'll definitely need time to, like, you know, put himself together and actually accept the fact that, yeah, he's not the powerful Phoenix anymore. He's just an ordinary man with no firebending. Yeah. Now, as I was saying, you know, like, I feel bad for Azula, and I think Azula can be redeemed. The things that she has done in the past, the wrongs that she has done, the sins that she has committed, obviously that cannot be redeemed. But she can do more good things in the future. If she actually decides to redeem herself, she can actually do more good for the world and, you know, make up for her past mistakes. That's one thing she can do. And I hope that she actually does that, because she's just an unfortunate character and she has always been walking the wrong path. So everyone deserves a second chance, and she never got any. She always thought the path she was walking was something that was needed. She thought that power equals to respect, power equals to friends. She equated everything with power, and she was wrong. She is probably realizing it later and little by little. And the fact that she's so prideful is probably not letting her accept the fact that, yeah, I was wrong. I really hope Azula redeems herself. She's a great character, I have to say. Like, it's such a great character seeing her, like, you know, being captured and imprisoned forever. It doesn't sit actually well with me. So I really hope in the future she redeems herself and she becomes a better person, you know, like a normal better person. And yeah, okay, that was the whole thing with Azula. Now the biggest thing, Aang versus Ozai. Wow, that was something. Ozai actually dug his own grave. He basically, like, you know, pushed Aang into the protruding rock, the place where he got shot, got, like, you know, triggered, and Aang went in the Avatar state. And as soon as he went to the Avatar state, all the past Avatars were like, you know what, it's our turn to take over. And they were hell-bent on killing Ozai. Like, obviously, Aang was not the only one who was in control of himself at that time. All the past Avatars were. And they were like, you know what, we can see Ozai is in front of us. Let's just kill him. Like, yeah. And all of them started. My God. I have to say, that was the most satisfied moment of this whole anime. Seeing Ozai run away like that with fear-stricken, like, you know, with a fear-stricken face. Oh my God, like, he was literally running away. He was like, nope, I'm out. I'm not facing that. Like, what the hell is that? Like, Aang is floating. There's like a air bubble, whatever you call it. And then there's this fire chain, the rock chain, and the water chain, and yeah, all the elements all together, and bam, that's it. So Ozai basically dug his own grave. The battle is fantastic. Obviously, we see how, like, you know, Ozai always tries to overpower Aang, but Aang does something which negates that, and Ozai can't do anything. He tries to kind of fight back, but obviously, like, Aang is in the Avatar state with all the... Now, here's one thing. Like, I can kind of realize this. I don't know. Like, I feel like... So, Aang's Avatar state is this strong. So, couldn't he just defeat Ozai anytime? But I guess it would have been a little difficult because Aang has mastered all the elements now. I'm guessing that's why he can use the Avatar state so well now, because he has mastered everything. Yeah, that's probably the reason. And that's why only now that he went to the Avatar state, he could easily overpower Ozai, because he himself has mastered the elements. And I'm sure there has been a lot of other, you know, complications if he tried to defeat Ozai before, because obviously, like, he wouldn't have so many allies. Zuko wouldn't be with him. Also, if he decided to fight Ozai before, he probably would have had to take in Zuko as well, defeat Zuko as well, and Azula. So it would have been a bigger problem, and I think, like, you know, obviously Sokka wouldn't know the swordsmanship skills, Toph wouldn't be there, and all this stuff would have happened. I'm guessing, before this, he also went to the Aftar state, but he definitely wouldn't be able to defeat Ozai. It is because of so many different things that he went through, the different elements that he went through, the different techniques that he learned, different people that he met, all the friends that he has. Because of that, he is able to actually defeat Ozai now, and also because he met the lion turtle. That was also another biggest thing of this, because if he defeated Ozai, what would he do after that? That's the bigger question. So it is only that this episode, after so many episodes, he's able to defeat Ozai after he went to the Avatar state, because he's ready now. And that's what he did. He defeated Ozai. He was almost going to kill him, obviously, because he was in Avatar state. And in the end, Aang decided that no, I'm going to do something different here. And since the lion turtle told him how to control someone's inner energy instead of the elements, he knew what to do. There was a big risk there, but you need to take bigger risks to do stuff like this. So at the beginning, he kind of releases Ozai, and Ozai is like, "Ha, you're a fool, you're weak." He tries to defeat Aang, but Aang is like, "Nope, I know, I knew that was coming from a long time ago." And Aang just imprisoned him and started bending his inner energy. Now, for a moment, I thought maybe he was going to make Ozai a good person. I don't think that's so easy to do, but I thought maybe Aang was doing something like that. But it turns out it's a lot simpler than that. He took away his firebending, which I think is probably the best conclusion to this. He has no firebending. What can he do? Zuko is a Fire Lord now. So, yep, I think that's the best conclusion that they could have come up with. And yeah, Aang was able to do that. Aang bended his inner energy and took away his firebending. He was getting overpowered for a moment there, but I'm sure, by the end of it, Aang's unbreakable will was able to overpower Ozai. And since he has gone through so many things, that's why he was able to overpower Ozai with his will. Otherwise, he wouldn't be able to. So since this huge journey he went through, because it was the end of that journey, he was able to do so many things. Otherwise, he wouldn't be able to do. So it's not as simple as I was thinking. I was thinking he could have just defeated him before if he went to the Avatar state. Yeah, it's not that simple, I guess. Because he went through this long journey, learned so many things, got so many friends, mastered the elements, that's why he can do this. So yeah, and I'm sure this energy bending thing that he did was probably something that only people who have mastered all the elements can do. And yeah, so the turtle basically saved them, by letting Aang know, by teaching Aang what to do at that situation. So yeah, and Aang came to a decision by the end of it. It was his decision to go through this, and he could have just said that, "Nope, I'm not doing this because I might die." But he decided to do this, and he decided to save Ozai as well, in a way. And it was kind of funny to see Toph and Sokka kind of trash talking him. And he's like, "I'm the Phoenix King," but then he falls down unconscious. Oh God. Yeah, that was good. I was very much content with this episode. My God, I loved seeing Ozai running away with that fear in his eyes. I love that, and oh boy, that was great. And then the aftermath, everything is okay. Zuko and Mai gets together back again. Sokka and Katara gets back their dad. Suki's back with the Kyoshi Warriors. Ty Lee joined the Kyoshi Warriors, which is kind of nice. And here's the thing that I was going to talk about. You remember when Ty Lee said that, "I didn't want to be a part of a pack, a part of a group who are like all the same." It's kind of interesting to see that this is basically kind of like that in a way. The Kyoshi Warriors, all of them put the same face paint, they wear the same clothing and everything. They're like part of a group, and this really shows that she was able to overcome that. that problem, that little thing that she had within her heart of, no, I don't want to be a part of a group. I want to be an individual. I want to be recognized as an individual. He was able to overpower that, and she was able to go past that. And she's now part of this group where she has so many friends now. And it's nice to see that. And so they basically became friends in prison. Oh God. And Tali showed them some pressure point techniques and everything, and they were impressed with her, and they were like, okay, you can join. Oh boy, that was good. And yeah, it's nice to see like all the other, like, you know, side characters as well. They are also getting everything now. I don't know what happened to Iroh. They didn't show Iroh in the end, but I'm sure he's fine. You know, he captured Ba Sing Se, you know, the prophecy that he went through as a child, it came true. He reconquered Ba Sing Se. Ba Sing Se is all with them. Fire Lord Ozai is behind bars. And Zuko becomes the Fire Lord. Aang is with him. And it's kind of like, you know, similar to that episode when we get the flashback of Roku and Sozin, you know, like both of them together. And hopefully the future is not like that. You know, Roku and Sozin's future, what happened? They became enemies. I'm sure that will not happen here. History wouldn't repeat himself this time, at least, because Zuko and and Aang will make the world better place again with peace, like, you know, like filled with peace and harmony. And Zuko goes to Ozai and asks him, where is Mom? Which answer they do not get and give. And I think the answer is probably given in one of the comics, which I'll check it out later on. And yeah, and now here's the thing. I wonder what's going to happen to Ozai. As I said, I'm guessing he'll probably be here for quite a while, unless and until he himself realizes that, yeah, the things that I've been doing is wrong, and he realizes the things, you know, he should have not done. And I don't know if that day will come. I feel like Ozai is pretty irredeemable, but as they say, everyone is redeemable. Maybe this guy is also be redeemable. It'll take probably a lot of time, but he'll probably be become a good person in the end. And yeah, and we don't know anything about Azula, so that's something. Maybe there is something. Maybe we'll get to know in the comics or something. I'll check out the comics after this. I'm quite interested in seeing what's happened after this. So yeah, and that was it. And then in the end, we see everything is in harmony. Sokka's painting, all the, like, you know, every, all the characters are here. Katara, Suki, Mai, Zuko, Momo, Toph, Sokka, Aang. Yeah, and then in the end, you know, like Aang and Katara, like, I really liked the fact that they didn't say anything to them. You know, they just hugged and kissed, like that was it. Like, they didn't need to say anything because all these things they have actually went through together. Like, you know, like all the discussions and confessing and everything, that is something that already happened. And Katara also knew that because it was a wartime, she wasn't able to give him a proper answer. So this, as soon as, like, you know, like this is here, like everything is over, like they didn't even have to say anything to each other. It's just like, yeah, that's it. Like, they just looked at each other and kissed. And yeah, happy ending. So now, I don't know, I think probably, like, this, like, whatever happens after this, like, you know, Katara and Aang together, I think it's probably more of this is in the comics. So yeah, I'm definitely checking out the comics. Like, Aftar has been such a great ride. Now, okay, that was this episode. Fantastic way to end it. And I really loved the way Aang came to a conclusion of what to do with Ozai. I'm like, yeah, that's the best way you can end this. Now, so as a whole, Avatar. Now, I've always heard about Avatar, you know, when I was a child, even I used to, like, you know, watch television, you know, all like cartoons and animes and stuff. I used to watch them on television, and I always saw, like, you know, Nickelodeon, they like, you know, like the the advertisement of Avatar the Last Airbender. And I don't know why I never checked it out. Probably because I had, like, you know, like, obviously, like, when I was a child, I had like a specific amount of time I was allowed to watch television. I had some other shows that I like, you know, religiously checked out all the time. For example, I used to watch Beyblade. I used to watch a few others as well. Like I used to watch Digimon as well, Naruto, a little bit of Dragon Ball Z. Like all these things I used to check out, and that's why I never got the time to check out after. And I always heard it, you know. And then obviously after internet became more prevalent and I started YouTube, I decided to check it out. And honestly speaking, I really didn't know what to expect. Now, I've heard it was really good, but like, you know, unless and until you see it with your eyes, you wouldn't be able to understand how much good a show actually is. And I, like, you know, I kind of went into Avatar with a very neutral, like, you know, sort of mind. I was not too hyped, you know. It was just like, yeah, okay, let's just check this show out. I've heard a lot of good things about it. Hopefully it is good. And I was with that mentality I got in, and my god, these few episodes has been such an enjoyable ride. And I can say now, yeah, like I am very much like, I can very much agree with all the people what they say, all the praises that people sing of Avatar. Yeah, they're completely correct. This is really one of the best shows that I've actually come across, and it's done so well. Like each and everything, like everything is done so beautifully. The animation is amazing, the story is great, it has a depth, the story has such a depth I've never seen. Like, you know, I've seen this in very few animes, this amount of depth in story. Like there's so many things that you actually need to realize about this, and so many deeper meaning behind a lot of things, and so many life lessons that this show can actually teach you. And the characters are so well fleshed out. Each and every character is so unique, has an individual character. They're not a copy-paste character of every other show. No, they have an individuality. You'll probably never forget any characters after watching this. Like usually in anime, people, we watch anime and we're like, yeah, this character is good, this and that. After 2 months, you actually forget about them because they lack individuality. A lot of animes, I'm not talking about all animes, I'm talking about a lot of animes. But you won't forget these characters ever, because each and every character is unique in their own way. They has an actual personality. It feels like this, they are an actual person. Another thing I loved about this show is the comedy. The comedy is top notch. It's on point. It's not like, you know, like basic simple jokes which you just are like, haha, that's funny, and you move on. It's not like that. Well-crafted, intelligent jokes, and Sokka is one of the best characters in this show. I love Sokka so much. Sokka, at the beginning, I thought Sokka would be annoying, I won't like him, but nope, he's probably the best character in this show. Like, if you had to, like, tell me, like, you know, ask me, like, who's the character you love the best in this, like, you know, in Avatar, I'll probably say Sokka. Like, I enjoyed Sokka the most, probably because of his, like, you know, intelligence, his his weird humor and the shenanigans he, like, you know, got himself into. I love him. He's such a great character. And and what else? Like all these things, like these things, like that makes the show such a joy to watch. And all, like, you know, this 3 months, I think 3 months I actually took to complete this. These 3 months that I was been watching this, it has been a ride. And yeah, I wholeheartedly agree with each and every people that sing praises of this show. This is definitely deserving of all the praises that it gets. And this is really one of the best things I've actually seen. And as I said, like, you know, I went in with a very neutral state of mind, started watching this show. That's why, like, you know, I knew it. This had a sequel, which is, I think, what's it called? The Legend of Korra, I think. Something, yeah, just a sec. Let me just check out. The Legend of Korra. I knew it had a sequel when I started it, but at that moment, as I said, I was in a very neutral state of mind. I was like, okay, let me first end, like, you know, watch Avatar, the Last Airbender first, and I'll probably not, like, you know, react to Korra. I was with that mentality I went in. And now I'm like, nope, I'm checking out Korra as well. So I am definitely going to continue this. From next week, I'm going to start Legend of Korra. And I think Legend of Korra has 4 seasons with 12 episodes each, so 48 episodes, which is a little less than Avatar The Last Airbender. Yeah, Avatar has like 61 episodes. Yeah, whereas Korra has 40 something. Let me see, 4 or 5. 51. No, 52. 52. 52 episodes. Okay, Korra has 52 episodes, which is a bit less than Aang after the last Airbender. But yeah, I'm going to check this out. And so next week I'll keep this, like, you know, the way I do it the same. Every week, 2 episodes I'm going to watch. So again, probably take 3 more months for me to complete Legend of Korra. So yeah, I'll be starting Legend of Korra from next week. So, and in the meantime, I'll also kind of on my own check out the comics, because I really want to know what happened after this. You know, there's the situation with Zuko's mom, Azula, all that stuff, and, you know, Aang and Katara. So yeah, that was a fantastic ride, and I'm definitely, like, you know, I'm definitely going to, like, I'm definitely going to suggest this, yeah, suggest this to people who, like, you know, ask me for a good show, who will probably ask me for a good show. I'm definitely going to suggest this. I'm sure most of the people have watched Avatar. Like, I was probably in the very minority that didn't watch this. Because this is something that has been coming, like, you know, have been going on from the childhood. Maybe people who, yeah, like, maybe younger people, like, you know, like, who have, like, very recently started watching anime, if they want to, like, you know, some suggestions and stuff, I'm going to suggest them this as well from now on. There are a few animes that I always give suggestions to watch to anyone who watches, you know, anime, who wants recommendations and stuff. I always, there are a few, like, you know, animes that I recommend them to for newcomers. So this will probably be one of them from now on. Like, yeah, you definitely need to watch Avatar if you have not watched it. This was an amazing ride, and I can't, like, you know, now if I had to rank this, I'd probably give Avatar The Last Airbender a solid 9.5 out of 10. Like, it's such a good, like, you know, show. It's such great of a show. And yeah, like, I probably don't have any all animes and all shows have, like, this kind of lackings that they have. For Avatar, I don't think there is any. I was never able to find anything lacking or anything, like, you know, like, any plot holes or loopholes or whatever, like, you know, you call them. I wasn't able to find any of them. It was such a well fleshed out show, and I love this. This is fantastic. So yeah, definitely watch this if you haven't. If you're here, you probably have watched it. It's like, what am I even saying? So yeah. So that's it. So thank you guys for watching, and this is the end of Avatar The Last Airbender. From next week, Legend of Korra is going to start, 2 episodes per week. So yeah, so thank you guys for watching. This is my reaction to the final episode of Avatar The Last Airbender Book 3. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to press the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel or you haven't subscribed, and comment down below anything you want to say, anything you want to let me know, your opinion on this show and it, as a whole in itself. You know, and all any other stuff, you know, your experience with this show and everything, let me know in the comment section. I'll definitely check them out. And yeah, so that's it. So thank you guys for watching. So I'll see you guys next week with 2 episodes of Legend of Korra. So until then, goodbye and have a nice day.